All right, so hey, Candace has a third-party bingo app. It's calling bingo numbers, and she suspects that it's not being fair. She wants to test if the numbers that are being drawn are truly random or if there's a pattern. And Candace says that she has keyed the numbers from the bingo game into Excel, right? And I don't know exactly what that looks like. I can kind of picture what it might look like. Here I have 750 numbers from A2 down to A751. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to be able to separate that into the column, that's the letter, and the number. All right, so I'm gonna be very careful here. Control shift down arrow to select all the data. And then on the data tab, text to columns. In the first step, step one, choose fixed width. In the second step, they're not gonna figure out what you're trying to do, so draw a line just by clicking between the letter and the number. But don't click finish, it's really important here. I don't wanna destroy the original data. In step three, the destination, I wanna change that destination to be the column next to the column. All right, and what that's gonna do is that's gonna just be a fast way to break out the letter from the number. Yeah, we could have done that with left and mid, but there's sometimes just an easier way to go. And then over here in column D, add the number one to do a count. And we could do the pivot table without this. It's gonna make the pivot table a little bit easier. All right, so now we have these four columns. The original number drawn, breaking out into the letter, the number, and then just a column of ones. Pivot tables are super easy to analyze data. Choose one cell in your data, insert pivot table. Let's put it on an existing worksheet and just click out here to the right somewhere. Click okay. All right, and then look over here on the right-hand side to the pivot table fields. Your pivot table, Candace, probably starts like this, field section and area stacked. I always change mine to be side by side, but the basic idea is the same. We have these four drop zones here, and I'm gonna check mark letter, and it's gonna go to rows, and then I'm gonna drag the count field down to values, right? And what we get here is we get the letters B-I-N-G-O, although they're in alphabetical order, and the number of times they were drawn. So in this particular case, it looks pretty good. I mean, it's an equal distribution. And if you want to rearrange these letters, it's pretty wild in a pivot table, you can do this. I'm gonna type an I here, and the 147 changes to 150, and then an N, and then actually the G was already there. Okay, so you could rearrange those just so it kind of looks better. All right, now, that's the columns. The columns seem to be pretty equally distributed from these 750 data points. I'm gonna make a copy of this pivot table, Control C, just come down here and paste. And from the second pivot table, I'm gonna change the shape of this. I'm gonna get rid of letter, and I can't just click number because it would go to the values area. So I take the number to rows like that. All right, and now these are the numbers, like here, G48, that's gonna appear in 48. And ideally, with 750, you would expect about 10 of each. But when I select all these numbers, not including the grand total, and come down here and look in the status bar, the min of 3, there's some numbers that were picked as few as 3 times, and the max of 19. Right? So, yeah, I don't know. Is that suspicious that some numbers were chosen 3 times, and some numbers were chosen as many as 19 times? That might be okay, and that might just be a problem that I have 750 instead of 7,500 or 75,000 data points. I did run this again with 75,000 data points, and in that case, the min and the max get closer, 941 to 1,067, and you'd expect 1,000 of each, right? So for this, to me, it looks fairly random. What I'd be concerned about is if you got something like this, where there was a high number of selections in the N column, not as many in I and G, and very few in B and O, then they're using a normal distribution instead of just random numbers between 1 and 75. All right, so if you get something like this, yeah, I'd be concerned that it doesn't seem to be working correctly. All right, so that's using a pivot table to create a frequency distribution. You could certainly do that with the frequency function, although frankly, it's a lot harder to do than a pivot table.